हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, डेली डिक्टेशंस के लिए और आपके डाउट्स के सॉल्यूशंस के लिए इस चैनल को अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन प्रेस करें ताकि आपको चैनल से जुड़ी सभी अपडेट्स रेगुलरली सबसे पहले मिल सके। दोस्तों, पिछली वीडियो में मैंने आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड की थी 100 वर्ड पर मिनट पर। अब मैं उसी मैटर की आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूंगा 80 वर्ड पर मिनट पर। 800 वर्ड्स की ये डिक्टेशन है, आपको मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं, बी रेडी फॉर इट। सर, वी आर हैप्पी टू डिस्कस द एग्रीकल्चरल प्रॉब्लम्स टुडे इन दिस हाउस। आवर्स इज एन एग्रीकल्चरल कंट्री। 60% of the people are dependent on agriculture. Our main economy depends on agriculture. When we look at the character of agriculture in the country, we find that even today, we are dependent on monsoons. If the monsoons are good, our agriculture is good. If the monsoons are not good, our entire agricultural sector will fail. That goes to say that in spite of the development in science and technology, we are mainly dependent on rain god for this agriculture. We need to look into the problems of the farmers. The main problem of the farmer is that we do not have a scientific approach. We have got the prestigious institution called the Indian Council of Agricultural Research on the one side. On the other side, we have got our farmers in rural areas of the country. This shows that the development in science and technology is not reaching the farm sector. Our farmer has got the same old seeds that he used to put. He is not able to generate more of food grains. On the other hand, the Western countries are producing high varieties of seeds. Now, coming to the cattle, the 60% of our farmers today are dependent on cattle like the cows, the sheep or the buffaloes. They get some milk from them and generate some income out of it. My plea is that if the scientists are able to reach these farmers, they can get better variety of breed, and with that they can get a better income. Today, our farmers are not able to use the modern scientific technologies. There are so many agricultural implements in the market, but our farmers are not able to use them for farming. Today, our farmers require financial help in the form of loan or subsidy. But when a farmer goes to a bank for the crop loan, he is not looked after well. We have got the directives from the Planning Commission about the grant of loans to farmers. But our bankers are not paying
any heed to it. They are not coming forward to give loans to the farmers. This way, the purpose of nationalization of banks is totally defeated. Coming to insurance, we have got the health insurance scheme. In the same way, we also should have crop insurance. We should see to it that each farmer should get an insurance cover for his crop. In this way, if the crops get damaged, they would get some compensation. We have to make all out efforts to see that the farmers get full compensation. If this is done, we will be able to help the farmer and also the economy. Now, I would like to say something about marketing. I must say here that marketing is a big thing. The government should see to it that our farmers are provided good marketing facilities. This will keep them to get remunerative price. As far as farmers are concerned, we find that they are in a very distressed state. We have to ponder over the fact as to why farmers are in such a state of distress. A farmer has to face a lot of problems right from the sowing of the crop to taking the final product to the market. He faces difficulty in getting good quality seeds, fertilizers, and water for irrigation. We have often noticed that the farmer keeps struggling to arrange for these requirements. The farmer is facing a great burden regarding cultivation. The farmer has to mortgage his land for meeting his daily requirements. This has resulted in increase of suicide cases amongst farmers. It is a matter to be taken up attentively as to why the farmers are committing suicide. This is a very unfortunate situation. Unless we formulate proper policies for farmers, cases of farmers' suicide shall not cease and they cannot move forward. The Honorable Prime Minister made an announcement the other day saying that the townships and cities should be improved. I have no bias against the towns and cities. Towns and cities should be provided with funds. But the fact remains that the villages should also be enabled to grow and improve. We are finding access to villages by way of the central scheme of providing rural roads. At the same time, the streets in the villages should also be improved. Arrangements should be made for imparting education to the children of the farmers. Unless this is done, farmers cannot make progress in the actual sense of the term. We have to take urgent steps to mitigate the problem of farmers and the problem of the country. What is needed today is a long-term plan.
तो दोस्तों ये डिक्टेशन थी 80 वर्ड पर मिनट की. आप अपनी मिस्टेक्स निकालिए और वीडियो के नीचे कमेंट करिए अपनी मिस्टेक्स. मुझे बताइए कि आपकी मिस्टेक्स आ रही हैं. आपसे मुलाकात करता हूँ अगली क्लास में अगली ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.